When I call the name, will the relatives come up and pick up the, and I want to say thank you to Diane for giving this all. And I don't see Diane here this morning. So this is for Taylor, okay? So one wasn't to come up.
She called last morning and said she wasn't.
Okay, well, this is, if you give it to Diane, make sure she gets it to Taylor. Okay. With congratulations. And Mina Wolf. Thank you, Jared. Congratulations. And we got Michael.
Honor David Clark.
Okay, Michael David Clark. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Last one is Alex.
We'll give this to Dr. Boggs.
Okay, there you go. And before we go into, let's just have a prayer for our graduates. Okay. Lord God, we give you thanks and praise for walking with these young folks and helping them to successfully complete this portion of their education. Lord God, I pray that your Holy Spirit will give them wisdom. Give them good experiences and bless them in all of their future endeavors, that they may rejoice in the power of the Holy Spirit and be moved in their lives, whatever their vocations, to serve your purpose, your will, with love. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. How greatly he exalts. You have given him his heart's desire and have not withheld the request of his lips. For you meet him with rich blessings, and you set a crown of fine gold upon his head. He asked life of you. You gave it to him. Length of days forever and ever. His glory is great through your salvation, splendor and majesty you bestow on him, for you make him most blessed forever. You make him glad with the joy of your presence, for the king trusts in the Lord, and through the steadfast love of the Most High, he shall not be moved. Let us pray.
Let's sing number 391.
Jesus, the King, takes us on the right path, accompanied by the Holy Spirit. And as your children, we are equipped to discern the right path, good from evil and life from death. Hear us, O Lord, as we silently confess our sin and shortcomings to you. O God, our trustworthy King, have mercy on us and forgive us our sins, so that we may seek to always live in the light of your love, with purity of heart and strength of purpose, so that no selfish passion may hinder us from knowing your will. There will be no weakness to keep us from doing your will, that in your light we may see light clearly, and in service find perfect freedom with you. We ask all this through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear the good news. The saying is sure and worthy of full acceptance that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. He himself bore our sins in his body on the cross, that we might be dead to sin and given and alive to all that is good. I declare to you, in the name of Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. Amen. King, trust God. Trust God. The King, Jesus, is in a very special and unique kind of relationship with God the Father, God Creator, Almighty God. And so some of those attributes, long life, blessed life, continuing life. You see, this past week, on Wednesday, was Ascension Day. That is the day that Jesus went up to heaven. So it's kind of like a second resurrection. Jesus came down. He was incarnate. He was in the flesh, in the blood. He was crucified on a cross. He died for us. And then he was put into the grave. And God raised him from the grave. And now, after 40 days, God is raising him to heaven, to the place where he began, before the world was even created. So, as we turn to the Gospel of John, Jesus has been speaking to his disciples, continuing that preparation that before his crucifixion, that things are going to happen, and I'm going to be away from you for a while. I will return. And in those times, you will be scattered. You will face tribulations. You will have many trials. But I will be with you. And now I must return to my Father. Okay? So that's the context in which Jesus begins to offer a prayer to his Father. And when Jesus had spoken these words, he lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, "Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that the Son may glorify you. Since you have given him authority over all flesh to give eternal life to all whom you have given him. And this is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I glorified you on earth, having accomplished the work that you gave me to do. And now, Father, glorify me in your own presence with the glory that I had with you before the world existed." This is the word of God. Thanks be to God. Lord, as we read your word, we ask your Spirit to join us now, to give us wisdom and insight and understanding of your relationship to us. Hear our prayer. Guide our thoughts. Grant us your peace in spirit and in truth. Amen. When Jesus had told the disciples that they were going to face some real challenges and troubles and be scattered, and that's pretty much what happened, and it's happened throughout the centuries, that Christians find persecution, except up till now in America, you know? We have been blessed richly to be kind of a haven, a kind of a sanctuary for Christians from all over the world. You know, you walk the streets of Chicago, and there's a mini universe there. There's a mini world. There are people from all over the world walking those streets. The shops, the restaurants, you know. I don't want you to get envious or whatever. Elaine gave me a cross from the Middle East made out of olive wood. Well, even in Chicago, I could find the Orthodox cross and have it in my hand. I was going to get this morning, but I'll get it to her sometime. But we spent 2 really long days in a conference, and where our friends, 2 friends from Ethiopia, were with us, and the people like you, part of the Ethiopian Mission Network, spoke about the trials and tribulations taking place in the Horn of Africa these days. And these Christians did it with joy in their heart, not despair, not seeking pity, but with joy. And because they know and they trust, just as Jesus' prayer begins with a confession of faith that has complete confidence and trust in their King, in their Lord, in their God. So, Rachel and I, Sharon Candle, shared the photographs that she was receiving even as we were in the middle of our conference, of the bombs going off in Khartoum, of the buildings that we know, buildings where Christians meet. You know, this kind of violence is a good opportunity to go and claim that valuable property that the church has in Khartoum. So they somehow, those buildings are being blown up, targeted. And when the Christians, they're scattered. That's what it means to be scattered. But they are scattered with trust that God has this under His care, that God will provide, that God will deliver and save. So it's that kind of faith that we're working in. In Ethiopia, the president of the Synod that I work with, Charlie, Reverend Charlie, I taught him Bible in the 10th grade. Now he's president of a Synod that is growing. When I was there, there were a few synods in Western Wallaga. Now they're adding 2 new synods. And when we talk about synods, we're talking about vast areas, you know. It's about 3 million Christians that he oversees. 3 million. And that's just one portion. And there's been strife between forces for some time, and Dimbidolo is a hotbed. That's where Rachel and I started. And the Christians live there, and it is a fearful time. You can be picked up, you can be detained, you can be thrown, you just sometimes disappear. And so all our students at the Gedada Bible School have been moved out of the school. The church's compound has been taken over. There are probably 1,000 troops occupying the church and Synod headquarters. Also, the high school that Presbyterians planted in Ethiopia. It has over 1,000 students enrolled right now. It has raised up Charlie Yosef. It has made new futures possible. That compound has also been taken over by troops. The whole region is filled with troops, and there is fighting that takes place. It doesn't make the 6 o'clock news, you know? And yet they meet for prayers. They sing hymns. So when we have fun with it here, don't we? We do that. But when we are reaching out our hands and hearts, and we say, "The peace of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you," it has real depth when you're in a time of tribulation. You have a real time of tribulation. One of the things that we also learned is how rich our country is, and what a blessing refugees are. Because they're Christians and they're fleeing. We had meals prepared by Ethiopians. We had meals prepared by Syrians. We had, what was that? Oh, Italians, the pizza. Okay, I take that for granted too. But these people find a haven and a refuge in our churches to begin with. And Wise County, you have to be a real intent refugee to find your way to Wise. But when we see somebody on the street and they look different, it could be an opportunity to share the peace of Jesus Christ with a person in the street. Now, I say all of that because Jesus was preparing his disciples for such a time. And he says to God, his Father, in this prayer, "God, glorify me, that I may glorify you. Glorify me, that I may glorify you. I have come. I have accomplished what you sent me to do. The work for me in this setting, in this reality, in this time, is complete. And so I'm returning to you. Receive me. Raise me again, that I may be with you the way it was before the world. This is an eternal promise for you, for me, for all the refugees I've been talking about." And friends, there was another story I was going to include in this, and the last 4 weeks have been tragic within the United States. That's a tribulation, to have people with guns and something's not right with them. I can't explain it. I don't know what it is, but they use those guns to bring loss, death, sadness, and death. And so, I think we ought to pray for those folks, and we would ask the Spirit of God to move within our general population restore peace and life in our daily living. It can be nerve-wracking being in a big city like Chicago, walk the streets with that in the back of your mind. So it wasn't fear. We don't fear. The Lord goes before us and with us, behind us, above us. Jesus Christ is everywhere. But we need to be, we ought to be mindful as Christians how we pray for the change to come in the people who have thoughts of not being loved, not being wanted, not being noticed, living somehow they place themselves on the margins. And so we need to reach out to those margins and share the love of God. Well, obviously I didn't write this all out for you, so it's come to you sort of as a jam. It's like jelly or jam or something. But I hope that it gives you some way to think about the coming week and all the events you will learn about, all the events that will happen, all the turmoil that these things may bring to us. And remember, God is with you.
Sing number 87.
Yeah. Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Let us return to God the offerings of our life and the gifts of the earth. Friends, I've been away for a week, and you have continued to be here, and people's lives have changed. One of those changes is the change for Claudine to be admitted to. I guess she's at the Havens. Where is she?
She's in Whitville.
An elder from Tazewell Church called me just to keep touch
would, when I, the only thing I wrote down was Tazewell, who I was going to call. So thank you, God.
Yeah,
is good.
And I have that information, her information.
Yeah, yeah.
But anyway, it's the church that Robert Guy goes to.
He's a member there.
Jim Thompson, wrong turn,
That's right. He's still in Georgia.
Yeah, but it's being released this, the 31st.
31st of this month. 31st. Okay, yeah. Thank you for that. Any other?
Speaking of Tazewell, I was there Wednesday. I could have visited, but didn't know she was there.
Yeah.
At a funeral. I need prayer for Diane Wright. She lost her mom, and we did the funeral or the visitation Wednesday in Tazewell. Diane is the one I stayed with when she had the heart procedure a couple of weeks ago. And also for Reba Stanley, who is the mother of one of our good friends, has recovered from cancer, but now it's back and it's wrapped. She had it in the lymph node, it's wrapped around her carotid, and she was in been surgery like 7 hours, and she's recovering. And
her first name again?
Reba.
Reba.
R-E-B-A, Stanley.
Well, I visited with Jeanette again, as I promised, and our Jeanette's been barefooted. I was sitting there talking with her, and she says, "There's a bear come down, was roughing around my barn." And before I could sink in, she says, "And I shot 4 times, and it only moved once." I said, "What did you shoot?" "Well, my shotgun." I said, "Well, can I tell folks you've been up there?" And she said, "I can tell you all." But as I was leaving, I said, "Jeanette, it looks like you mow more than an acre of grass." "More than an acre? I mow 5 acres. So, and it wore her out. She's probably done for a few days. Yeah. But she's hanging in there and trying to be tough. And really, it's really a struggle sometimes.
It is, isn't it? Yeah. And she's, I assume that her conversations with Claudine, which is almost a nightly thing for the both of them, is...
That's a burden that she's trying to deal with, not having that connection.
We need to continue to remember Mary in prayer. She's recuperating at home, and she's able to move around. She's had the wires were removed a couple weeks ago, so she can at least talk.
Man.
But it's still hard for her to move because she can't move her head from side to side. She's got a brace on it.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to go visit her, she just appreciates being visited.
Does she?
Yeah.
That's good to know.
Yes.
I have an older sister that's very sick.
Okay.
Her name's Carol Tracy.
Carol. Thank you. Sorry. Well, it's my joy, my pleasure, my privilege to stand before you behind this table, the table that we know as the Lord's table, the table in which we come to and we remember that the Jesus who prayed for us and who prays for us, the Jesus who bore our sins in his body on the cross, the Jesus who was raised from the grave to new life, to a resurrected life, to become our living Lord. And our living Lord, the same Jesus, was raised from the earth to the heavens. And so it is, when we stand in the place of this table, we stand in the presence of God. And I want you for a second to go beyond the community, to gaze heavenly, Jesus invites you to him. And as you trust and believe in him, God has given you to him and made you a child of God. So while we're at the table, just imagine that we're already in heaven, because heaven has come to us in the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. Be with us all.
Yes.
You know, the night in which our Savior, Jesus Christ, was arrested, he was with his disciples first in a small room. Probably was dimly lit, oil lamps. The whole crowd is sitting there, his closest, the people closest to him in this world were with him in that room. And he took the bread, and after giving thanks to God, he broke it. And he said, "This is my body, which I give for you. Every time you eat the bread, as a community of people, remember me." Likewise, after they had eaten, Jesus prepared a small chalice cup of wine, and he held it out to his disciples, and he said, "Friends, this is the cup of salvation. This is the cup of the new covenant. It is sealed in my blood, shed for you, shed for the forgiveness of sin. Take, drink in remembrance of me." And every time that you eat this bread and drink from this cup, you do proclaim the risen Lord until he comes again. Let us pray. Sovereign and holy God, we pray for the unity of the church in every place. We especially lift up to you this morning the churches in Sudan, the churches in South Sudan, the churches in Ethiopia. We ask you to direct your spirit . Give them a respite from the violence and the hurt and the pain and the loss, the sadness, that they may have time to glorify you with their amazing deeds in the midst of turmoil. This morning we give you thanks for East Gambela Bethel Synod in Gambela, who prayed this morning in their services for the Christians in West Gambela Bethel Synod, as they are under attack from another people group. And so, Lord, for the world, would there be, shall we pray, for one day when the whole world stands in your peace. We pray for leaders and people in every land. We pray that they are seeking your authority, your kingdom, to establish our communities and people in this land and in all lands in kindness, humility, love, and grace. Lord, we pray for all those whose lives have been changed. We especially raise to you Claudine and Jeanette. And I pray, Lord, that they will have opportunities to continue their friendship from a distance, that they will be able to continue their conversations by telephone. And I pray, Lord, that you will be their strength and stamina. We pray for Diane Wright, Reba, Mary, and especially Carol. We pray for these folks who know illness. And I pray, Lord, that you keep hope alive for them and in them, that your healing hand will touch them, and that your healing strength will guide them through each day. We pray for those who mourn, Lord. We ask that you be their refuge and hope in your promises of eternal life. Holy God, we are your children. We have gathered in your name at your table, a table that you prepared for us. Therefore, all praise and thanksgiving be unto you, ever faithful God. For you gather us at this table as your people in a covenant relationship. We thank you for sending us your Son, and we're thankful that he now is on your right hand. And he's also here with us at this table. At your table, O God, we remember your boundless love. And here it is that we experience your love again. And as a response, we surrender our lives to you and celebrate the life you give with joy and praise. Lord, we ask you to send your Holy Spirit to pour out the power of your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts of bread and juice, that they may be the body and blood of Christ, so that we may be his body in the world. And Lord God, unite us with Christ and one another by your Spirit until we share the feast with all your people in your eternal realm. And as your Savior has taught us, we are bold to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Friends, this is the body of Christ given for you. Take, eat in remembrance of him. Blood of Christ, give shed for you. Take, drink in remembrance of him. Gracious and God of great abundance, with this bread of life and this cup of salvation, you have united us with Christ, making us one with all of your people. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world and continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen. Let's turn to number 572. God is good, that God is great. Amen.
grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all.
Amen.